Hello everybody and welcome back to another Stinky Sasquatch video. This one is going to be the first episode of a brand new series that I'm going to be starting on this channel right here. And the reason I wanted to start this series up is because this is going to be the place where I'm going to be answering all your Stinky Sasquatch related questions. As you guys know, for the past few years now, I've been creating a lot of Stinky Sasquatch content. And although I'm helping a lot of people out with all my quick tips and tricks guides, I'm still getting a lot of questions on how to do this and that. So this is going to be the perfect place for all you guys to leave all your questions down below in the comment section. And I will do more episodes on this series trying to answer as many questions as possible in shorter videos just so that they are easier to digest. So that being said, let's just dive straight into it. So question number one that I've been getting from a lot of people in the past few days and months even. People want to know, what are the mystery project? And while I'm going to go with this question here, I'm also going to answer another question asking about all the fast travel locations. Now, as you guys know, as of right now, May 2021, there only are two mystery projects in the game. The Racetrack Mystery Project and the Mountain Cabin Mystery Project. Now, I know that a lot of people are talking about the Golf Course Area Mystery Project, but there's no official mystery project other than these two at the moment. So if you guys are looking to build up the mystery project, the first one is going to be in the mountain, all the way to the first level in the mountain. From the orange guy, start running to the left side, and that's where you're going to find the mystery project. Once you get to it, you will unlock the ability to now build it. If you go back home at the builder dock, he's gonna allow you to now build it, of course, for some money and wood. As for the racetrack mystery project, all you're gonna have to do here is, again, make your way to the racetrack and find the beaten down RV truck at the back. This current house right here belongs to the driving license guy that you are actually going to be able to talk with him, and he's gonna eventually tell you that he would love to have a bigger house. Now, getting this mystery project done, what you're gonna have to do here is just wait inside this house until about 9 PM or 10 PM when the driving license guy is actually gonna close down shop and come back home. This is when you're gonna have to talk with him, and he's gonna tell you about the situation he's living in right now. And by doing that, you will unlock a new mystery project. And next up, you gotta go back home at the builder dock, talk to him, and build up the new house. Of course, you are gonna need some money and some wood in order to do that. And these are the current mystery projects in the game. But that being said, of course, as you build these two mystery projects, you are going to be able to now fast travel to the racetrack and the mountain. And of course, the house, since you could always fast travel to your house. But there are definitely more fast travel locations in the game, such as the surf shack on the island, the cabin at the marina, and the apartment in town. Now, in order to get these fast travel locations, for the apartment, you are going to have to rent out an apartment in town, and then you're going to be able to fast travel to that location. But do keep in mind that you are going to have to pay a daily fee. I usually do not do that. Instead, what I do, I unlock the marina cabin and I then fast travel to the marina and then simply make my way into town. That is the best way to do it, of course, and you also save quite a lot of money by doing that. But if you're asking yourself, how you get to fast travel to the marina then? Well, it's pretty easy. Of course, it's gonna take a little bit of work, as you are gonna have to catch all the fishes in the ocean, deliver them to the fisherman here, and then he's gonna allow you to use his cabin. If you're wondering how I did it, go check out the video right up here or here and try to catch all the fishes in the ocean. Now finally, in order to fast travel to the surf shack, you are gonna need to finish all the surfing events. And in order to do that, I also created a guide on how to do it right up here or again here. And you're also gonna find all the links down below in the description. For question number two, I actually found this one on Reddit, although I also got a lot of comments about this subject on my previous videos. And although I already replied to them, I keep on seeing this question over and over again. So hopefully this will help more people out. So in order to get to the secret cache by 9 AM, you will need three things. One of them is going to be the rented apartment in town. The second is going to be a fast car, preferably the supercar, of course. And third, but this one is optional, you will need the fast running shoes. Now, getting these shoes is going to be a little bit difficult. I did create a guide on how to do it. Again, you will find the link at the top popping up right now or the link down below in the description. So once you got all these things, make sure you grab your car from the racetrack. Go into town, rent out an apartment, and simply go to sleep. As soon as you wake up, just simply make your way downstairs, jump straight into the car because the car is gonna be waiting for you in front of the apartment block. Drive to the location, jump out of the car, and start running to the cache. Now again, this is where I said that it's gonna be optional to use the fast running shoes, just because they are gonna save you quite a few seconds and you're definitely gonna make it there in time. But I did it without the fast running shoes quite a few times, and you can definitely do it. Question number three, and this one comes from Riley on my YouTube post. He asks, how many hours a day do you play to get all the coins? I don't really play that much. You don't really have to play this game that much in order to get the coins. All you gotta do is just use the tactics that I've already shown you guys. And if you are getting bored of just racing on the mountain pass over and over again, just try to do the others. Like, do a little bit of racing, collect some more oranges and sell them, collect some trash from the ocean, and also, do not forget to sell some trash food to the bear. I have created some really great strategies for all of you guys to use, and just go ahead and watch my videos right up here, or as usual, down below in the description, and start getting rich. Question number 4 from 70 Acre Studio. He's asking, when a new update is coming out, how will I know? Well, of course, the best way to know when a new update comes out is through the App Store, because the app is going to automatically update. If an update has been pushed, when you're going to want to play Sneaky Sasquatch next, instead of hitting play, it's actually going to tell you to hit update. So don't worry about it. But if you want to know more news about upcoming updates, sneak peeks, and everything new about Sneaky Sasquatch, make sure you subscribe and tune into the channel. Question number 5. This one is coming from Tobison Brown, and he's asking, any new tips on how to catch the sea cucumber? Well, the thing about the sea cucumber is that there isn't really a secret about it. All you gotta know is that the sea cucumber is the smallest fish, as at the moment, as you know, there are 3 sizes of fishes in the waters: small, medium, and large. But just go around and try to catch the smaller ones. And there's absolutely no specific strategy of doing it. You just simply gotta drive around with the boat in the ocean and try to catch the smaller fishes. Eventually, you will get it. Me personally, I've been very lucky in the past few streams because I caught one sea cucumber in every single stream. And I have no idea how that happened. But maybe eventually you're gonna be lucky as well. And you're gonna get yourself a full backpack of sea cucumbers in no time. Alright guys, there we have it. 5 questions answered in just a few minutes here, and I will be doing more of these videos in the future if you guys enjoyed them, so make sure you leave your comments down below. And as a bonus answer to all the flooding questions coming in lately, when's the update coming out? I don't know. I wish I knew, but I'm still hoping that the update is gonna come out this weekend. As you guys know, judging by the history of Rack 7 updates, they have all been pushed during the weekend. So yeah, all we gotta do right now is just wait and see, and be patient, because if the update is taking so long, well, that means it's gonna be epic. Alright everybody, now before we end this video up, let me just thank all my members for supporting the channel and all the kind super chats during my streams, because they are making these videos possible, and without them, making videos just like this one would be 10 times more difficult. And if you guys want to support this channel and help it grow even more, there is gonna be a link down below in the description, or click on the join button at the bottom next to the subscribe one, and I will see y'all in the next one coming up really soon. Bye everybody!